हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर हिमांशु एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द प्लेन्स एंड एक्सिस ऑफ द मूवमेंट। सो बिफोर स्टडिंग अबाउट द प्लेन्स एंड एक्सिस ऑफ द मूवमेंट वी हैव टू नो सम टर्मिनोलॉजी। सो व्हेन डू वी से अबाउट दिस टर्मिनोलॉजी, फॉर एग्जांपल आई राइट हियर एंटीरियर पोस्टीरियर medial, lateral, superior, inferior, distal and proximal. So I'm going to talk about these one by one. Let's see, when do we say something is anterior to something? For example, let's focus on this picture here. This is our skeleton. This is our clavicle. These are our ribs. And we have the attachment of the pectoral muscles like this. So we can say that the pectoral muscles are present on the anterior aspect of the body. Similarly, we can say that on the posterior aspect of the body, we have the trapezius muscle. And when we talk about medial and lateral, when we say something is located medially or laterally, we have to imagine a midline. Then we have to see what structures are located medially or laterally to this midline. We can see here the scapula is located laterally to the midline, and if we take this as a midline, we can say the spine is located medially to this midline and the upper limb is located laterally to this midline. When we say something is superior and inferior, for example, here we can see this is our humerus, this is our radius, and this is our ulna. So the radius and ulna are located inferior to the humerus bone. I'm trying to give you guys an example so that you can understand better. Similarly, we can say the tibia is located inferior to the femur bone. When we talk about distal or proximal, we have to take a point of reference. For example, we say the elbow is proximal to the wrist if we take the wrist as a point of origin. Similarly, if we say something is distal, which is far away from the origin or point of reference, we can say the foot is distal to the knee. If we take knee as a reference, we can say it is distal. So these are few terminologies which you have to remember. And now we can move on to the planes and axis of the movement. Here in this picture, we're going to talk about the planes and the axis. So basically the human movements are described in three dimensions based on a series of planes and axis. There are three planes of motion that pass through the human body. They are namely the sagittal plane, the frontal plane, and the transverse or horizontal plane. So the sagittal plane lies vertically and it divides the body into right and left part. We can see this is our sagittal plane. It is dividing. Just imagine this is a blade. This is a very big blade and it is cutting the body into two halves. So after we cut, we are left with the left part and the right part. So basically what I'm trying to say is the sagittal plane divides the body into left and right part. Similarly, the frontal plane also lies vertically and divides the body into anterior and posterior part. Frontal plane, the transverse plane, it lies horizontally and it divides the body into superior and inferior parts. We have talked about the planes, now we are going to talk about the axis. an axis. So you can imagine a straight line around which the object or the body rotates. We call that an axis. So the movement of the joint takes place in a plane and it will be about an axis. So basically there are three axes of rotation. They are the sagittal axis, the frontal axis, and the vertical axis. The sagittal axis, it passes horizontally from posterior to anterior, and it is formed by the intersection of sagittal and transverse planes. So we see this is our frontal plane, this is our sagittal plane, and this will be our horizontal plane. So we get this sagittal or horizontal axis at the intersection of these two planes. The frontal axis, it passes horizontally from left to right, and it is formed at the intersection of frontal and transverse planes. So this is the frontal or horizontal axis from left to right, and it is formed between the intersection of frontal and transverse plane. So this is our frontal plane and this is our transverse plane. So at the intersection from left to right, we'll see the frontal or horizontal axis. The vertical axis passes vertically from inferior to superior, and it's formed by the intersection of sagittal and frontal planes. If you imagine, we get the sagittal plane like this, and we get the frontal plane like this. So between the intersection, we get the vertical axis. So for a better understanding of the axis, I'm going to make something here. Let's imagine this is a human body. And this is a straight line passing vertically through the midline. This is a straight line passing horizontally. And at their intersection, this is another line passing. So this line is going to be our vertical axis. This is going to be our horizontal axis, and this is going to be our sagittal axis. It's also known as frontal. This is vertical, horizontal, and sagittal. So after this, we can talk about the movement in each of the planes. As you know, the sagittal plane, it divides the body into left or right. We can see the movements happening in the sagittal plane about the frontal axis. As you can see in this picture, so this is the right part of the body depicted. So this was our sagittal plane, and we can see the body was divided into right and left parts, and we can see the right part of the body. So these are the movements in the sagittal plane which are about the frontal axis. You can see the flexion of the limbs, the extension of the limbs, the hyperextension of the limbs, the flexion of upper limb and lower limb. We can see the flexion of upper limb, the wrist, extension, flexion, extension. As you can see here, the flexion of upper part of the body, the extension of upper part of the body, and the hyperextension. The flexion of the neck, the extension and hyperextension of the neck, the dorsiflexion and plantar flexion, Talking about the movement in the frontal plane about the sagittal axis. The frontal plane divides the body into the anterior and posterior aspect, and anteriorly we can see these movements. You can see the anterior part of the body, the abduction and adduction of the limbs. We can see the radial deviation, the movement of the wrist towards the radius bone, and the movement of the wrist toward the ulnar bone. We can see the eversion and inversion of the foot. We can see lateral flexion of the head towards the left and towards the right. So, movement in the transverse or horizontal plane above the vertical axis. So, this is our vertical axis, and this is going to be our transverse plane. So, we can see the body is divided into superior and inferior part, and along the vertical axis we can see these movements: the external rotation of the limb, the upper limb and the lower limb. We can see horizontal abduction and horizontal adduction, the supination and pronation along the vertical axis, the rotation of the head to the left and to the right along the vertical axis, and rotation of the body. We can see the superior part is rotating to the left and the rotation of the lower part to the right in the transverse plane. That's all I want to talk about the planes and the axis of movements. Thank you.